So we have a lot of different types of things related to logging technology besides just tools. So we have a huge collection of documentary photographs that show a lot of different stages of the logging process. And one of the most astonishing images I found researching this exhibit is actually this image, and it shows basically an exhibition run by a gentleman named Tex, who was a high climber at Windling for Booth Kelly in 1926. And this is part of a Labor Day picnic they held every year, but this particular year they brought in the Kendall Ellis Photography Studio to document it. So we have pictures of every single part of this particular day, from the guys cooking the hot dogs to the kids' talent show to this really amazing image. And what this image shows is the process known as high climbing, and high climbers were the superstars of the logging camp. They were the highest paid worker outside the cook and the management, and their role was to set what was known as the spar pole. And the spar pole was really important to a type of logging known as high lead. So this particular pole, which was a tree that was still in the ground, is they would use this particular pole to set up the pulley system that they would then use to hook up to a steam engine and winch the logs up and move them around the campsite. So this is at the particular logging site they're working. So what he would do is he would climb up the tree using only a couple ropes and his boots and log as he went. And what's really amazing about this is we have a picture of him getting started on his run this particular day, and he's wearing a pair of jodhpurs and a nice little golf cap. So he dressed up for this. He even has white gloves on. So he would climb and limb and climb and limb, and then when he'd get to as tall as they wanted the spar pole, which a lot of loggers are very good at eyeballing heights, he would chop the top off. And when you're dealing with a tree this high, and especially fir trees that are a little bit on the thin side, it bucks. So as he cuts it and the top falls off, the tree is bucking, so he would just have to hold on for dear life. So what this image shows is him in the process of what's known as topping the tree right before it starts bucking back and forth. Tex was part of a family of high climbers. There's also the Polly family that was three generations of high climbers. And these guys would also do a lot of stunts and things that they got to be kind of famous for. So this is a really interesting kind of forgotten part of logging history, is what these guys did. And they tended to be really popular and have a lot of social status as well, especially in a place like Windling. So it's really amazing to have this picture.